This is a production of PBS 39.
Well, we hope you'll learn something new in this next story as well. Students who sign up for Dr. Larry Haas's course on magic at Muhlenberg College harbor few illusions. They go into class expecting the unexpected and ready for a magical experience. Here's our newest addition to Team Tempo, Grover Silcox, with a look at this one-of-a-kind college course and how it transforms students into serious magicians.
Keep your hand in place, madam, and continue to ascend. It is by your perfect concentration the young lady remains floating in thin air.
Oh, excuse me, madam. Sorry to keep you hanging around.
Some magicians make objects vanish into thin air. This magician makes students appear in droves to take his course on the theory and art of magic.
The first time I did the program in the fall of 1999, I knew I was throwing a great party, but I didn't know if anyone else would show up for it. And the great news was that everyone showed up.
Dr. Lawrence Haas, a philosophy professor at Muhlenberg College, has combined his love of magic with his passion for philosophy into a course for would-be magicians, a course in which students learn to amuse and delight while asking the deeper questions magic seems to inspire.
I know that in the art of magic, I'm teaching students how to create performances of magic, but I'm also teaching them how to think about their own interests and how to express their lives and how to make choices that reflect their deepest desires.
The course offered at Muhlenberg College attracts and impacts each student magician in a different way.
You're going through the philosophy, the mechanics, the manipulations, of course.
When you think of college, you think of tests, homework, and studying, and you don't necessarily think of playing with a deck of cards or performing.
Some students use Dr. Haas's class to enhance their performance in other areas. Katie Smith, a junior at Moravian College, is able to take the class through an arrangement with area colleges. She sees this course in magic as a way to re-energize her first love for singing opera.
I had been feeling a little disenchanted with my current course of study, and this class has definitely helped me re-find my enchantment.
The serious student of magic soon learns that Dr. Haas has more up his sleeve than simple instruction. He offers a multifaceted course that includes how-to exercises, lectures, and demonstrations from internationally famous practitioners, such as master magician, author, and philosopher Eugene Berger.
The Muhlenberg program is amazing because not only is it a benefit to the magic world of magicians, it's also a benefit, I think, to people.
Students have no illusions about what's expected of them. They know that this class is for those who seriously want to dazzle and delight, and that the final grade is based on real criteria, including how well they perform.
Final exam was maybe one of the hardest final exams I took in as an undergrad, where you have to come up with your own 10-minute routine and present it in front of a jury of 5 professional magicians.
Okay, so
and they're the ones giving you a grade. In here, right now, could you see your card anywhere in here?
No.
Can you see it now?
Being able to perform in a way that creates an experience of astonishment for an audience is a really high bar.
Dr. Haas's course in misdirection gives direction to each and every member of his class.
I definitely think that it's going to be a huge part of my life.
I love it. Right now it's a hobby. I take any performances I can get, and I'd love to do it full time.
For these students, there's more to magic than pulling rabbits out of a hat. With their final bow, they leave this course as philosopher magicians, using illusion to explore reality, and always ready to amaze and delight.
I love to create that space where it's okay for people to be like, all right, you know what, I can forget about work, I can forget about my job, I can just have fun and forget everything and play this wonderful game of what if with this magician.
For Tempo, this is Grover Silcox reporting.